Hello, this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy IV, The After Years. Let's climb up Mount Hobs. Try to find Ursula around here somewhere. Fortunately, these ones, pretty easy. Whee! Yeah, it's gonna be like that for a little while, so... Oh, wow. Don't even really have to pay attention to elemental weaknesses that much. I mean, even the Hollow Man monks, even Krillin, can one-shot those guys without a Fire Claw. That is sad. They got beat up by Krillin. But anyway, we got some new treasures on Mount Hobbs since the last time we were here. Can't take out a skeleton in one hit. Oh, well. Well, sometimes you can, sometimes you can't. Gosh, I hope I don't run out of potions. We have no way of healing ourselves without them. If only there were an ability that would allow us to heal ourselves like white magic would. Well, either that or they burned her alive. One or the other. Well, let's see what we can find. I don't remember this being part of Mount Hobbs. Well, if you missed the interlude, they added this to the After Years. Before they made the interlude. So, I'm not sure how that works. Supposedly something with the phase of the moon, or something or other, changing the lay of the land, or whatever. Pick your ridiculous excuse. Now remember, unlike, well yeah, I would imagine, like the original Final Fantasy IV, you cannot get the bomb summon from bombs, or gray bombs. So, if you're trying to get that, now that won't work. Not even in the original. Oh well. Not that I would ever really want to use it. One thing you want to be careful for with the tiny mages is that they can counterattack your attacks. So you might want to watch out for that. So make sure you one-shot them, essentially. Obviously, Monk B is not going to be so good against them. Do we have, like, a kick command? Good. Here, everyone, kick them. Or Yang could just one-shot them with his kicks. Awesome. He's just that badass. And behind his mustache, it's just another fist. He's just that good. We could save there if we really wanted to, but... Nah, I don't think so. Wait for it. There we go! Oh yeah, Yang has a new ability, I think, in the After Years, doesn't he? I never use it, but yeah, cover counter. So, it's basically like, what were those two abilities in the DS version? I'm trying to remember what they were. Well, there was counter, obviously, but then there was the draw attacks, yeah. Imagine draw attacks counter in the DS version, except not quite as obscene. Yeah, but that was obscene in that game, but you needed that. Uh-oh. They got her cornered. She can't handle all those monsters. She's had no formal training. Whoa. This is the kind of training they put these monks through. For some reason this seems familiar. Oh, I have to actually enter in commands. I was expecting this to be an automatic scene for some reason. But, well, it seems Ursula can hold her own. How did she ever get so strong? I mean, she's never received any formal training. What, she just watches us? But, anyway. Yeah, we've been here before. I like the reference, though. For boss time! Now, Ursula... Well, it's pretty fast. She has a chakra command, which is basically like, I would imagine almost any other Final Fantasy game. It restores HP. No MP restoration, but not like we really need that. So, basically the difference between Ursula and Yang is that Ursula, well, has chakra, but as far as stat-wise goes, Ursula is faster... Or has more speed, while Yang is slower and has more strength. Ursula does also get access to some female exclusive equipment, like, oh, we can use focus on it if we wanted to. But, like, she could get the Minerva robe, or other such, or Minerva bustier, whatever it is. But anyway, let's just wait for it. Unlike the DS version, you don't need to defend. Let's do that. There we go. Heal yourself, I guess. Remember, Monk B is a little weaker, so you want to have him go after the bombs. Unless he got another multiplier. He might have. When he gained a level, he was at like 15 strength before. Well, alright, there we go. Easy enough. Hooray! Well, that was an easy rescue mission. You insolent fool! Well, she was insolent. This is the wilderness? How dare you go outside and get a breath of fresh air for a change? Well, she just wanted to prove herself. Huh? What shooting star? This isn't Star Tropics. Oh, well then, why didn't we check it out? I'm sure it's nothing to worry about. Well, yeah, that is true. She hasn't even played this JRPG before, and she knows how all the rules work. Well, time to pack our bags and go home? I wouldn't worry about it. Oh, yeah. Okay, send the monks with her, then. Yeah, he's played this JRPG before. Yay! More party members! Oh, sorry, I spoiled it 2 seconds in advance. And she is a permanent party member, not a guest, so... Alright, let's check her out. I mean, check out her equipment. But anyway, she's not going to need those claws. That's one reason why I'm not worried about it, because someone's going to have to be in the back row. So we might as well let her be in the back row. So let's see, let's give him the ice claws, him the flame or lightning claws. Doesn't really matter who you give what, as long as they have their claws. Alright, there we go. Dr. Claw? No. Well, let's continue over and investigate whatever's going on. Oh, this part. Somehow it's not as annoying going this way as it is the other way around. I don't know, maybe it's just me. Okay, let's speed things up here, since I'm going to be fighting pretty much every battle anyway. Can she... Nope, she can't hit them from the back row. Oh, well. Whee! Try to let Ursula do, well, not that anyone else can do the healing, but try to let her do the healing instead of attacking from the back row. There we go. I wonder if she has that extra attack multiplier yet. Ooh, almost. Well, maybe not almost, but she's closer than everyone else on speed there. Remember, for every 16 speed, you get another multiplier, attack multiplier, and for every 8 strength, you get another attack multiplier. That's something that's pretty critical in this tale compared to the other ones, let's say, because you're going to get a lot of strength and agility boosting equipment, like the fairy claws, we already got the power armlets and such. So, yeah, that's just something you want to keep in mind when you're figuring out who to give what. I wonder if Yang can kick them all. Or at least the little ones. Well, let's find out. But yeah, now we have unlimited healing with chakra, so... I like how they fit that into the tale, because usually if you don't have a white mage, you're pretty well screwed. Ooh. Will that work? Yes! Okay, there we go. Finish them, Ursula. Oh, you can't even do anything without your claws. Oh, well. Well, that's one way to go about it. All right, here we got the Kenpo Gi. We want to give that to, let's see. Well, no one really needs it. I guess Ursula could use it, but... Oh, you know what? I probably want to give that to, Or wait, Yang already has it, doesn't he? Okay, I guess give it to him for now. Yeah, I'm surprised those spirits take so long to kill. Oh yeah, that's right. They're probably, like, resistant to my flame claws or something. Okay, yeah, that would be a problem. Well, I'm not gonna remove them. Right now, not really a big deal. Yeah, we might want to get a little extra damage there with focus. Yang also gets better HP than Ursula, too, but, well, that goes without saying. Uh-oh. Attack! There we go. Okay, whew! Yeah, that guy's got a lot of HP. Not as much as, well, yeah, a lot more than these guys, actually. Everyone kick. There we go. Kick it up. Gatling hogs can also counterattack your normal physical attacks. But I guess they don't counter kick or something. Well, whatever works. Man, they got skeletons lying around everywhere. It's a little creepy. Have we made it? Yes, okay, we're back to the start, I think. Or, well, in the original game, but... I do like how they keep that save point over there to the left. Uh-oh. Maybe Ursula can kill it. Alright, go Ursula! You can actually do something remotely useful! Besides healing. She will eventually see actual combat use. Just right now, we've got too many monks, so... Oh well. But yeah, she is really good. I love speed a lot more than... strength, if I had to choose one or the other. She's actually one of my favorite party members in the game. She's fast, she's strong. What more could you ask for? Maybe she can kick from the back row decently well. Probably not. Wow, she actually did decent damage. Well, okay, I guess that's a use for her. I wonder if kick gets affected by the back row. Probably. Oh, hey, there's a little guy there. Hey, how's it going? Oh? Well, okay, yeah, let's go check it out. But anyway, if you need to, you can buy stuff. I don't. Might be nice if we could have gotten some equipment from him now that we actually have the money to buy it, but no, no. Oh well. Ooh, and another power armlet. Who do I want to give that to? Probably... Let's see, the monks can't really use it. Oh well, he might be able to. No, he already has one. Okay. Well, I'm gonna figure out how to rearrange my equipment off screen. I'm gonna list my setup in the video description, and then we'll check out the shooting star. Can we make an impact on the upcoming events? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy IV The After Years. This is HC Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!